Homefront is a first-person shooter. It's set in the year 2027. One of the main hooks of Homefront is its premise. It's an Occupation USA setting.
Homefront's an opportunity for us to tell a story that's near and dear to our hearts in an environment that's very familiar but's been warped beyond recognition.
It's a story of really survival and adaptation.
What it feels like to be part of a resistance fighting for your country, to give the last full measure for something that you really believe in. In a lot of other games, you know, you blow into a place, you know, a slum or something like that, and you kill 100 people, and at the end of the level, you jump into a helicopter and fly away. You know, at the end of our levels, there's no helicopter. You have to stay and live with the things that you did.
Bringing 2027 to life in kind of a suburban and rural setting all comes down to picking the things that everybody's extremely familiar with. The buckets are now water collectors. The children's toys are still there, but they might just be repurposed for something else. This is a survivalist nation now.
Now it's about being a member of a resistance cell in occupied America and doing what it takes to liberate your country from this alien oppressor.
The idea for Homefront actually came from a few different angles, really. One of them was Red Dawn. You know, I watched that and that was very inspirational.
John Milius is like a great American film creator. Apocalypse Now, Red Dawn, and Conan.
He's just the type of guy that has this natural creative ability. He just knows when something's good.
And he really brings like 30 years of storytelling experience to us.
Speculative fiction basically means we are giving the audience what-if situations.
What if America was invaded by Korea?
What if this happened? And then filling out the answers to that. And that's really where the high premise of Homefront comes from. We said, what if USA was occupied? What would it be like to experience that future?
Historically, there are multiple examples of sudden rises and sudden falls. Ancient Greece, Mongolia, Japan.
So when you say, how could a mighty power like the USA fall? It's really a combination of elements. It's the decline of the USA due to internal factors and global geopolitical situation. And there's a war in the Middle East. There's Saudi Arabia and Iran involved, and that disrupts oil supplies. And the rise of a new power.
United States' big weakness is their just-in-time economy. Your local supermarket has 3 days worth of stocks on the shelves. If something gets in the way and disrupts that, that's it for our country. You know, our country is on the razor's edge. The North Koreans are the perfect enemy. The only North Korean that anybody knows is Kim Jong-il.
This morning comes the news of Kim Jong-il's death. North Koreans greet their new supreme leader, Kim Jong-un.
The North Koreans actually have the world's fourth largest standing army, which a lot of people don't know about.
Now, what happens in the storyline is that we have North Korea being unified with South Korea to form one country where it has the economic power and modern military equipment. And within the storyline, we also have North Korea being in conflict with Japan.
And training on American weapons and getting a lot of modern training and really building up a military from the other countries in the East Asia region.
North Korea is able to invade the United States through its well-prepared military strikes that involves a EMP strike.
EMP is an electromagnetic pulse. It sends out a particular type of energy that blankets the Earth, and what that does is it deactivates modern electronics.
You see things that aren't supposed to be happening. You know, this little town, Main Street, and it's got ma and pa shops and bakeries and banks, but there's soldiers and there's barbed wire. And that's kind of the genesis of where this phrase, the familiar has become alien, has come from.
We want to show America, but twisted.
War in the back suburbs, war in the elementary school playgrounds, baseball fields, high schools. Golden Gate Bridge becomes a battlefield. That's pretty darn alien, if you ask me.
It takes seeing an enemy hurting innocent people in front of you to make you understand why you're doing the things that you're doing.
This is your backyard. This is literally home front.